though they themselves are elected. So the Universal House of Justice resides in Haifa. It was first established in 1963 on what we call Rizwan, a holy day, at that time by 50 national spiritual assemblies. Those 9 members that are elected serve for 5 years. Their communication line is, they're at the top. So everything is below them. Their duties are the supreme administration of the entire Baha'i world. The selection process is by secret ballot. And again, no campaign of any kind. And who elects them? The 9 members of every national spiritual assembly in the world.
How many people is that?
I'm not sure how many national spiritual assemblies there are today. At the time that they were first elected in 1963, there were 56. I wish, you know, I should.
Over 100.
I don't know how many.
Over 180.
Pardon me?
Over 180 national spiritual.
Over 180 now.
Yes.
It says at the 10th annual convention in 2008, there were 167, so now over 180. Okay.
So that means times 9 people for each assembly?
Well, this is 160, yes. You want to know how many members, how many people?
How many votes?
Yeah,
right.
And then they're voting for 9 people, so it's 9 times 9.
Yes.
Times 9. Uh-huh.
Okay.
You know, Baha'is have no ordained professional priesthood. The type of government might be called a nonpartisan democratic self-government. For those of you that worry about those names, let's go to slide 4 for a minute. Let's look at what comes below, and then we'll go back to that chart in a little while. But this starts below the Universal House of Justice. I want to start with the appointed institutions, those that aren't elected. Some Baha'is don't know that, but there are 9 members in residence in Haifa that serve on the International Teaching Committee. Those members are appointed by the Universal House of Justice initially in June of 1973, and they serve for 5 years also. They communicate with the Universal House of Justice. They coordinate, guide, and direct the work of the Continental Board of Counselors, who are below them. They make recommendations to the Universal House of Justice regarding the direction of the teaching work of Bahá'í Faith worldwide. They're appointed, and they're appointed every 5 years on May 23rd. Now, I want to point out also, let's go to the next slide, that this arm that was referred to as the learned. Baha'u'lláh sometimes says there are the learned, and there are the, the rulers. In the elected body, Baha'u'lláh referred to as the rulers, those who administer the affairs as a group, not as individuals. And the learned are those that are appointed as individuals that represent moral leadership. They have no authority to command, but all the institutions and individuals in the world really are morally obligated to listen to them because they've been recognized as being moral leaders in the Baha'i Faith throughout the world. Their functions are loosely defined. Their duties are divided into 2 general categories. One is propagation, which means teaching, analysis, and the other is protection, which means to protect the Baha'i Faith from things that might try to tear it apart, or the communities, or the nations, or the regions. The Continental Boards of Counselors are in residence in home countries throughout 5 continents. They were established in 1968 by the Universal House of Justice. There are 5 boards: Africa, the Americas, Asia, Australasia, and Europe. Again, they serve for 5 years. For example, this might be different today, but at the time that I gathered this, there were 81 counselors worldwide. For example, 13 counselors were in Europe. There were some recent changes that might change that number, but that'll give you an idea. They mainly communicate upwardly through the International Teaching Center that I referred to previously, but they also communicate directly with the Universal House of Justice upwardly and then downwardly to whoever they want. Yes?
I'm a little bit confused because
yes.
I learned about these different committees and things, mm-hmm. and then every year it seems like it's different. Mm-hmm. Where does that come from? Is that the House of Justice making those changes, or how does that happen?
Yeah. Well, in the beginning I mentioned that there are some things that won't change, that never change, and there are other things that can change. The one thing that we know won't change within this 1,000-year period is we will always have the Universal House of Justice, and we'll always have local houses of justice, now called local spiritual assemblies. I can't guarantee anything beyond that, because those are the things that are specifically ordained by the Bahá'u'lláh. Now, probably we'll also always have national spiritual assemblies or national houses of justice, because Abdu'l-Bahá started those, and I don't believe that the Universal House of Justice will change anything that Abdu'l-Bahá put into motion as well. Anything else that you see is subject to change.
Just by anybody, or how?
No. Starts at the top from the Universal House of Justice. So since the Universal House of Justice is in charge of the entire Baha'i world, then they could change anything not specifically ordained by Baha'u'llah or interpreted by Abdu'l-Bahá, or for that matter, the Guardian Church of India. Emily?
Just along the lines of, like, this is an ever-advancing civilization and everything, that it can change. We're advancing at all times. So, I mean, we shouldn't kind of expect that to be the space. It's just kind of evolving.
That's part of what has to happen in the world today, which is so one of the wonderful things about this revelation is that certain things throughout history are immutable laws of God. From the time of Moses when he revealed God's Ten Commandments, what religion ever told you that you should lie, or steal, or cheat, or kill, except in self-defense, maybe? So certain laws are immutable and unchangeable. Other laws need to be changed for the age in which they live, which is really the reason why God sends new messengers from age to age in the first place. In this dispensation, you'll see things that never change and things that change according to the laws, not the laws, but the needs of the time.
It seems like it's every year.
It'd be nice if it was. It means we're progressing.
Yeah.
That would mean we're making even more progress. Next slide.